In this tutorial, we'll learn how to georeference an existing HECRAS model to a real-world map. The first thing we're going to do is open an existing HECRAS model. GeoHECRAS offers a couple of different ways to do this. We can either select Import HECRAS Project from the Input Ribbon menu, or we can select File Open from the Quick Access toolbar at the top left of the ribbon menu. We're going to go with this second route and select File Open to open a HECRAS model. For this particular demonstration, we're going to open up one of the existing Army Corps HECRAS unsteady flow examples. This example is a dam failure model of the Bald Eagle State Park Reservoir, which is located just upstream of the city of Lockhaven in northern Pennsylvania. This is a fairly large HECRAS model, one that's nearly 25 miles long. There are lots of storage areas and structures associated with this model, including several bridges and a dam. As we zoom in, notice that GeoHECRAS will start showing more and more visual detail about the model. First, we start seeing cross-sections, followed by bank stations. And as we continue to zoom, more and more information is displayed. The software uses adaptive visualization, which only shows the level of detail needed based upon the current zoom level. The next thing we will do is add a background base map. To do that, we'll right-click on the Map Data Layers panel and select Add Base Map Layer. This will bring up the Add Base Map Layer dialog box, allowing us to select the base map to display. Although this is a personal preference, we're going to use the hybrid map from Microsoft Bing. This is a decent map with good aerial photography and labeling, but the choice of base map is up to you. Click OK to close the dialog box. Next, we'll need to select the map coordinate system that corresponds to the map coordinate system that the HECRAS model was defined with. To do this, we're going to select the File ribbon menu, and then click on the Map Coordinates menu item. From the displayed Map Coordinates backstage page, we can browse the continents, countries, and states to select the map coordinate reference system that we want. However, an easier way to select a map coordinate reference system is to use the search function. Since our project is located in Pennsylvania, we can simply type in PENN into the search field, and the software will display only those coordinate systems that are in Pennsylvania. From the displayed listing, we can see the different map coordinate reference systems that correspond to Pennsylvania. The coordinate system that we want is NAD83, Pennsylvania North, in feet. After clicking on the coordinate system entry, we can see a preview of the coordinate system bounds in the map preview window. To select that coordinate system, click on the Apply button. Once that's done, we can see that the software has automatically cropped the Microsoft Bing map to the map coordinate reference system limits. The software has also reprojected the map to the selected coordinate system projection. The next thing we will want to do is georeference the already loaded HECRAS model by assigning the current map coordinate reference system to it, which is shown at the bottom right side of the application. From the Map Data Layers panel, we're going to click on the Properties button next to the HECRAS layer. This will display the HECRAS layer properties dialog box. Next, we're going to switch to the Spatial Reference tab in the dialog box to assign the current map coordinate reference system to the HECRAS model. Click on the Assign Current CRS button. After clicking on this button, we see that the coordinate reference system has been assigned. Click OK to close the dialog box. Now, looking at the map view, we see that the HECRAS model has been georeferenced and everything is correctly aligned. To see more detail, we're going to zoom into the map by right-clicking and choosing Zoom from the displayed context menu. Then, drag a box over the area of interest, and the software will zoom into that area. We can see from this tutorial how easy it is to georeference an existing HECRAS model to a base map.